Hello students, welcome to all of you Shiksha 360 and today we will discuss case study number 6 on ABM and this case study belongs from your chapter number 12, clear from your chapter number 12 that is basically time value of money. As we have discussed in basically part 2 in the theoretical session regarding the effective rate of interest, clear? So in this session we will discuss one case study on the effective rate of interest, clear? And I request to all of you basically when we are discussing the case study, first of all you will pause the case study and try to solve the question yourself, clear? And after that if you are facing any error then you can go through the question basically how I am solving, clear? But first of all I request to all of you please go through the question yourself, clear? So let's start the case in on your screens now. Basically what it says that Mahek is planning to invest how much amount? 25 lakh. Clear here, Mahek is planning to invest 25 lakh in bank deposit for 1 year. Clear, basically for how many times? 1 year. And all the banks offer an interest rate of 12% per annum. A rate is 12% annum and time is 12 months. Clear, for 12 months deposit. Mahek has inquired deposit application, clear? Basically Mahek wants to earn maximum to maximum benefit, so Mahek has inquired deposit application forms of four banks, clear, of four banks, and the details are as follows, clear? And the details are as follows. Basically there are four banks, M, N, O, P. So basically bank M interest will be credited at half yearly basis, clear? Bank M says that basically interest will be credited at half yearly basis, and bank N, basically what bank N says that basically bank N says that interest will be credit at year quarterly basis, and next one is basically bank O says that interest will be credited at monthly basis, and bank P says that interest will be credited at a weekly basis, clear? Interest will be credited at a weekly basis, clear? So it depends upon case to case, basically it depends as per the terms and condition, or as per the basically it shows that basically as per the applications or condition basically which bank will offer how much a rate, clear? So before moving towards next point, basically here we are basically what we are going to calculate here is basically here we are calculate the effective rate of interest, and that is effective rate of interest is equal to, as basically I have already provided, P is equal to 1 plus R power N, clear? It depends, clear, if it is half yearly, quarterly, clear, according to that it is to, we can say that A is equal to P 1 plus R upon N into R, clear, into R, clear. For more information and for any query you can check the session number 2, clear? So let's move towards the first question, clear? Let's move towards the first question, clear? First question says that if Mahek cares for every extra rupees, clear? Basically Mahek cares for every extra rupee, clear? Basically it means that which bank will get the maximum interest to the Mahek, clear? So which bank will be preferred, clear? Which bank will be preferred, clear? M and OP, clear? Basically as the interest is calculated here, interest is calculated on half yearly basis, here it is to quarterly basis, here it is to monthly basis, and here it is to be weekly basis, clear? As we have already discussed in the session, clear? Basically on weekly among the four it gives the maximum interest, clear? So basically bank P will be preferred by the Mahek, clear? Bank P will be preferred by the Mahek, clear? So basically it depends upon case to case, clear? As we have already discussed, clear? As we have already discussed this concept in the session, so basically bank P will give the or offers maximum interest, clear? It offers basically maximum interest on investment, offers maximum interest on investment. Next one is basically if Mahek prefer the bank O, clear? Basically amount receivable by her will be, clear? If the Mahek prefer the bank O, basically how much amount they will receivable, clear? So basically amount is equal to P 1 plus R by N upon R into N. So it depends, clear? Here P is to be 25 lakh. So let's move. Basically, how much bank O? Basically, bank O will be interest will be credited on monthly basis. Clear? Interest will be credited on monthly basis in the bank O. Clear? So we have to take the condition according to that. Clear? So in this case, we have to take the conditions according to that. So basically, so in this case, R is to be, because it is monthly basis, rate of interest is 12 by 100.12. this is 12%, but it is on monthly basis, so it is divided by further 12, so it comes out to 0.01. clear? Rate comes out to be 0.01. clear? And time is to be multiplied by 12. clear? Because compounding, it is to be 12 times. So when we are going to calculate, 25 lakh into 1 plus R 0.01 by 12. So when we are going to calculate this, it is to be 25 into 1.01 power 12. Clear? Into 1.01 power 12. So basically 1.01 power 12, it comes out to be 1.1268. So when it will be multiplied by 25 lakh, so it comes out to be 2817062.57. clear? It is basically more than 0.50, so basically we will go to the 2817063. clear? So this is our answer. Clear? This is our answer. Clear? Basically, these are the directly, we can either we can say that straightforward question, but not as much straightforward. Clear? Basically for that, clear, basically for understanding all these concepts, basically you have to know the formulas. Clear? You have to know the formulas, and also you are able to understand the concept in these cases. Clear? And also you are able to understand the concept in these cases. Clear? I think this question is clear to all of you. Now move to the question number third. Clear? Now move to the question number third. Clear? Here what it say that, it says that basically if Mahak prefer the bank M, clear, if Mahak prefer the bank M, amount receivable by her will be, clear, then now we have to understand, basically now we have to remember, basically bank M, how it will compounding the interest. Basically bank M will be compounding the interest at half yearly basis, very easy. So basically what we do here is R is equal to 0.12 divided by 6. It comes out to 0.02. Sorry, half yearly, so it will be divided by 2 times. It comes out to 0.06, and time is to be 2. Clear? Here n is to be 2. So A is equal to P plus R, it comes out to 25 lakh. 1 plus rate is to be 0.06, n is to be 2. Clear? So when we are going to calculate this thing, clear, 1.06 power 2, 1.1236 multiply by 25 lakh. So it comes out to be directly very straightforward thing. It just comes out 2809000. It says that 28,09,000. Clear? It says that basically 28,09,000. Here I will write one more 9. It is to be 0. Clear? 28,09,000. Clear? Here you have just remember A is equal to P plus P is A is equal to P 1 plus R power N. Clear? R is the basically rate of interest which we have to calculate as per the terms and condition, and N is the number of times it is to be compounding, which I have, I think, writing at this one here. Basically N is the number of times it to be compounding. Here we can say that it is to be capital R, clear, which they are given. Clear? But as basically further we have basically simplified the formula. Clear? R is the effective rate of interest, and N is basically the number of times it is to be compounding. So the formula is A is equal to P 1 plus R power N. Clear? It is the effective formula. Clear? Now move to the question number 4. Clear? Now move to the question number 4. What is the minimum rate? Clear? What is the minimum rate bank N should offer? Clear? What is the minimum rate basically bank N should offer to attract Mahak? deposit. Clear? Basically, to attract the deposit, if the maximum of the above four returns. Clear? Here it is already mentioned. What is A's return is 2818250, and principal value we have already know 25 lakh. Here we have to calculate the R. Clear? Here we have calculated the R, and N is to be. So here we have to understand basically what is the value of N. 4. Clear? If the maximum of the verb 4 returns. Clear? Basically total number of returns is to be 4. Clear? Basically 4 times compounding. So A upon P 1 plus R power N. As we have to calculate the R, here is to be 2818 upon 25 lakh 1 plus R power 4. So when we are going to calculate this 2818250 divided by 25 lakh, it comes out to be, here I will write here, 1.1273 is equal to 1 plus R power 4. So we will divide it by power 4 both on side. So this comes out to be 1.127. 1.0304 is equal to 1 plus, here it is to R by 4. 1 plus R by 4. Clear? Because we have to calculate the interest here. Clear? R by 4. So when we are going to calculate, so here R comes out to be by taking this as LCM, and R is equal to, comes out to be 4.1216 minus 4. It comes out to be 1.1216. So when we are going to calculate this, basically in the percentage, it comes out to 12.16%. Clear? 12.16%. So this is our answer. Clear? So this is our answer here. Clear? So rate of interest here is to be 12.16%. Clear? Here if it is to be power 4, so here it is to be divided by 4. Clear? Here it is to be divided by 4 for understanding. Clear? Basically maximum 4 returns, they are saying that. Clear? Here they are saying that basically how many maximum returns. So the maximum returns here it is to be 4. Clear? So maximum returns here it is to be 4. Now move to the next question, basically last question of this case study. Basically, if M agrees to credit interest at continuous compounding. Clear? Basically this concept I think we have not covered, basically the formula for that. Basically if bank M agrees to credit interest at continuous compounding basis, so then what will be the return for MEH? Clear? So first of all we will understand what is the formula for the continuous compounding. Clear? For the continuous compounding, basically the formula is, basically continuous compounding interest A is equal to P E is basically exponential R into T. Clear? A is the amount, future value, P is the principal initial value, R is the interest rate, and T is the time. Clear? R is the interest rate and T is the time. Clear? And in this case, effective rate of interest. What is the effective rate of interest in this case? Is to be E power R minus 1. Clear? This is the effective rate of interest in this case. Clear? So this is the continuously compounded interest. A is equal to P E power RT. Clear? So now let's move towards the question. What it say that? Basically question say that if bank M agrees to credit interest at continuous compounding basis. Clear? Then what will be the return for MEH? Clear? Then what will be the return for MEH? So basically we will move towards the directly the formula. A is equal to P E power RT. So principal here is to be 25 lakh. And E is equal to exponential. I think all of you are aware that E is equal to 2.71. Clear? E is equal to 2.71, or we will take up to how, it depends. Clear? How to how much decimal we will take. Basically we will take up to only 3 decimal, 2.718. clear? And T is equal to 1 year, basically, but we have to, basically we are compounding, it is to be 12. Sorry, basically compounding continues. So T is equal to 1 year time, and rate of interest is 12%. So it comes out to be 0.12. Clear? It comes out to be 1, 2, clear? So basically when we are going to calculate this one, it is to be 2.718 power, it is to be 0.12. So when we are going to calculate 2.718 power is to be 0.12, clear? Because t is 1. So it comes out to basically when we are going to it 1.271275, clear? Here it is to multiply 225, clear? So when we are going to multiply it by 25 lakh, clear? So it comes out to be 28,18,707 rupees, clear? It comes out to be 28,18,717, clear? I think my answer is 28,18,717. I think there is not any options, clear? So basically this is basically close answer. We will take this one, clear? If it will comes out in the examination in like this way, clear? Basically 1 point, we will again calculate 1,275 into 25 lakh. Clear? I think there is 28,18,707, clear? But as we have discussed, the effective rate of interest is ER minus 1, but here we are doing that also, clear? Wait a minute, we are taking this one, but effective rate is ER minus 1, clear? So we will take that one, 25 lakh into ER, this one 1.1275 minus 1, clear? So it comes out to 25 lakh, so I will write here, it comes out to be 25 lakh minus point, basically what comes out to be is 0.1275, clear? So it basically when we are going to 1.1275 minus 1.1275, clear? So basically minus 1, so it comes out to be 25 lakh, clear? So what we will get here, so here we will get the exact answer here we will get the only this one 3,18,750, clear? But this is the effective rate, but for the continuous compounding, clear? But for the continuous compounding, what will be the return? So basically we are going to calculate, this comes out to be 28,18,750, clear? So here we will get the, this is the interest, clear? This is the interest. So what we will do, 25 lakh plus add, we can add the interest here, clear? We can add the interest here. So we will get the exact answer here, clear? 28,18,750, clear? So I will suggest to you, basically you will do in this way, clear? By taking out the effective interest rate and by multiplying it with the principal value. So you are going to calculate here the interest, and after that basically you will add the amount, clear? You will add the amount here, principal plus interest, clear? So this is the formula to calculate the exact answer, clear? This is the formula to calculate the exact answer. Basically this is also the formula, but here we are also checking that we will get the answer but not exactly the same, clear? So basically how we can calculate the answer, basically we can calculate the answer, first of all we have to calculate the interest, and after that we have to, amount is equal to principal plus interest, clear? And the effective rate of interest is to be e power r minus 1, clear? In this case the effective rate of interest is to be e power r minus 1, clear? I think this case study is clear to all of you, and if you have any doubt, any query, then you can comment or then you can ask in the group for your doubt, we will discuss your doubt, clear? So basically this case study is totally depends upon the effective rate of interest and very very important for your examination point of view, and we will expect these types of case studies basically in your examinations also, clear? So thanks to all of you for watching this case study.